This is Mission Control Houston. You're looking at the International Space Station flight control room as a team of flight controllers watches over all of the systems aboard the International Space Station, along with the Expedition 34 crew aboard. The team throughout the daytime hours here in Mission Control is managed by Flight Director Royce Renfrew. He is on console throughout the day, and of course, a team of flight controllers supports International Space Station activities around the clock every day of the year to support the ongoing activities aboard the complex. A Soyuz spacecraft docked to the POISC module of the International Space Station supports the three crew members on board right now. Those three crew members are made up of Commander Kevin Ford and flight engineers Oleg Novitsky and Yevgeny Tarelkin. Novitsky and Tarelkin on their first voyages into space and, of course, long-duration space flight. Kevin Ford on his second flight into space, his first flight as a long-duration crew member. He previously flew to the International Space Station on the STS-128 mission, the flight that occurred back in August and September of 2009. The crew members have been aboard the station since October 25th. They are awaiting the arrival of three more crew members that are just about to head to the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. The three crew members heading there are Dr. Tom Marshburn, you see on the left. In the center, Roman Romanenko, who is the commander of the Soyuz spacecraft, the TMA-07M, and Canadian astronaut Chris Hadfield on the right. Those three crew members have just been certified to continue with their training and head toward quarantine. They'll be heading to Baikonur on Thursday, December 6th, for the final 2 weeks or so of their training activities ahead of their launch on Wednesday, December 19th. Aboard the International Space Station, the current crew members, three crew members, spent a fairly quiet weekend. They checked on some experiments on board the station, conducted routine housekeeping activities, conducted some Earth observation, and also visited long distance with their families here on the ground. Monday, today, the crew focused on experiment work and housekeeping as well. That work included activity with the water processing and water recovery systems on board, one of the components of the elaborate environmental control and life support system aboard the International Space Station. In addition, some experiment work at the Microgravity Sciences Glove Box has been taking place throughout Monday by Kevin Ford as he focused on work with the investigating the structure of paramagnetic aggregates from colloidal emulsions, a long acronym that essentially is an experiment that studies the fundamental behavior of magnetic colloidal fluids under the influence of various types of magnetic fields. These fluids are classified as smart materials, which transition to solid-like state by the formation and cross-linking of different microstructures in the presence of those magnetic fields. Here on Earth, these materials are used for vibration dampening systems that can be turned on and off. The hope is in the future this technology has promise to improve the ability to design structures such as bridges and buildings to better withstand earthquake forces. The Russian crew members on board focused on Earth observation, including an ocean observation experiment that is designed to help measure the shape, structures, and characteristics and color contrast of formations on the ocean that can potentially help in what's known as bioproductive ocean areas for the sighting of sunlight and sun glint on the ocean for the fishing industry. In and around timelined activities, the crew members exercise twice a day and perform their routine cleaning activities of air and water filters on board as well. They also were given a heads up today to that the ground-commanded feeding of the Madaka fish experiment, which is in an aquatic facility in the Japanese experiment module, is taking place. That's a routine as well. And tomorrow, Tuesday, the crew will take some water samples from that aquatic facility for some water quality testing. Crew members will end their day Monday with a daily planning conference, long-distance talk with all of the flight control teams around the world supporting their mission, and then they'll head to bed about 3:30 this afternoon, Monday afternoon, U.S. Central Time, and they'll wake up at midnight tonight to begin their next day aboard the International Space Station.